Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So let's move for the next lesson from the science. Okay, so what is the name of the second number lesson? That is components of food. So today we will start our second number lesson, and the name of that lesson is what? Components of food. So as you know, in our previous lesson we have discussed about why we need the food. Why we need the food? Let's revise why we need the food. We need the food because to get energy, to keep our body healthy, to maintain our body, also to development of our body and for the repair of our body, and to get the enough amount of energy to do the different activities. Okay, so for all this purpose we requires the food. So today in this lesson we will discuss about which are the different components of a food. Okay, and from that components, if there is a deficiency of that components, or if we will not have that components properly in our diet, then which diseases will get suffer, or which are the sources of the different foodstuff, that from that foodstuff we are getting the different types of the components. So in this lesson basically we will discuss about the deficiency diseases which causes due to the lack of different components. Also we discuss about which are the sources that we are getting from the different which sources we are getting the components. Okay, so let's start. Components of food. So there are the basically two important components of the food, that are nutrients, roughage, and with the help of the nutrients and the roughage there is one more component of the food we require, that is nothing but water. So our body in and all requires all these different things in a different amount. Okay, so what are the components of the food? Nutrients, roughage, and water. These are the three main components of a food. Okay, so what is mean by nutrients? Let's see what is mean by nutrients. Nutrients are the substances that an organisms need for growth, repair, and maintenance of its body. Okay, so in our previous lesson we have discussed that we need the food to get the proper growth, to get energy, to maintain the body. Okay, so from the food what we are getting? From the food we are getting the different nutrients. Okay, and why these nutrients are necessary for our body? Because nutrients are the substances, okay, that an organisms need. Why that nutrients needed by an organism? For proper growth of the body, also to repair and to maintenance of the body. Repair and maintenance means what? As we have discussed before also, if you are having cuts, wounds, then after certain period of the time it get healed. Okay, so this is what repair and the maintenance of its body. Okay, so this is the definition of the nutrients. Once again I will repeat it. Nutrients are the substances that an organism needs for growth, repair, and maintenance of its body. Okay, so this is the proper definition of the nutrients. So there are the different types of the nutrients that we are including in our daily diet. Okay, so let's see which are the different types of the nutrients. So the different nutrients are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. Okay, which are the different components? Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. All these are the different components which we are including in our daily diet. Okay, so in this lesson we will discuss about all these different nutrients, from which are the sources of that nutrients, which are the diseases causes due to the deficiency of these particular nutrients. So all these things today we will discuss deeply in our particular lesson, that is what? Components of food. So from the nutrients, first we will discuss the number one nutrient, that is nothing but what? Carbohydrate. Okay, so let's start. First nutrient we are going to discuss, that is carbohydrate. So carbohydrate is the main source of the energy. Carbohydrate gives us more amount of energy to perform the different activities like to walk, to talk, to run, to move, to play, and etc. So we require the energy to perform the different activities, and that basically more amount of that energy we are getting from the one nutrient, that is nothing but what? Carbohydrate. And that's why carbohydrate is called as what? Energy giving food. The carbohydrate is called as energy giving food. Okay. And this carbohydrate is having two types. And which are the two types? Let's see. The carbohydrate is having two types, that are sugars and starch. Okay. Carbohydrates are having two types, that are sugars and starch. Okay. So all these two types we are going to see one by one. Before that, again I will tell you that the carbohydrate provides us lot of energy to our body, which our body requires to do the different activities, and that is the reason the carbohydrate is called as energy giving food. Very important term, students, keep in your mind, that is what? The carbohydrates are known as energy giving food. Okay, why? Because it provides us more amount of energy. So from the different two types of the carbohydrate, first we will discuss the form sugars. Okay, so the sugar is the simple carbohydrate forms here. We are getting the sugar, or it is found in the form of fructose and the glucose. Okay, so these fructose and glucose, these are nothing but the different types of the carbohydrate, and from that fructose and glucose we are getting the sugar. Okay, so sugars we are getting, or we found that sugars in the form of fructose and glucose. So the sugar is what? Simple carbohydrate that we are getting from, or that found in the form of fructose and glucose. Next one, the taste of the sugar is, as you know, it is what? Sweet taste. Okay, the taste of the sugar is what? Sweet in the taste. They have the sweet taste. Also, they gives us instant energy. So as you know, this is the 21st century. It is the century of the instant. We want all these things in the instant. Okay. So in this way, we can say that the sugar is also giving the instant energy. That's why, you know, if you are having someone is get unconscious. Okay. Then we are providing them some chocolates or some sweet juice. We are giving to that particular person. Why? Because of the sweet taste, that is nothing but what? Sugar. They are getting the instant energy. Okay, so in this way we can say that sugar gives us instant energy. Sugars give instant energy, and we are getting the sugars from, we are getting that sugar in the form of glucose and the cane sugar. Okay, so cane sugar means a water, that sugar, table sugar we are telling, or the sugar that we are using in our kitchen. We are adding in our juices, we are adding in the tea, that is called as what? Cane sugar, or it is also called as what? Table sugar. Okay, so which are the sources of the sugars? Glucose, cane sugar and all fruits. Okay, from all that fruits we are getting the sugar. So the fruits, like we can say that banana, pomegranates is there, also watermelon is there, pineapple is there, custard apple is there, strawberry is there, all these are the different fruits, and that they also contains the sugar. So from that fruits we are getting the sugar. So this is all the points regarding sugar. What we have discussed, that sugar is nothing but a simple carbohydrate. They have sweet taste, they gives us instant energy. And which are the sources of the sugars? Glucose, cane sugar and the different fruits. Okay, so let's move for the next type of the carbohydrate, that is nothing but what? Starch. Okay, so starch is the complex carbohydrate. Now complex means what? There are the so many different molecules combines together to form a starch. Okay, so the starch is a complex carbohydrate, and the starch is a preserved food material for the plants. So as we know, the plants are performing the photosynthesis process, and from that photosynthesis they are having the food. Okay, so that extra food they are storing in the form of starch. Okay, they are more preparing the food in a more quantity, but that all quantities doesn't get used by them. Only the some amount of the food is get utilized by the plant, and the remaining all the food they are storing in the leaves in the form of starch. Okay, so this starch is the storing material of the plant, and it is the complex carbohydrate. The plain or the pure starch is tasteless and odorless, and it is a white powder.
sugar and the starch, then starch gives us, or the starch provides energy slower as compared to sugar. Okay, as comparatively they provide the energy slower. Okay, so here we have discussed what sugars gives us instant energy, but as compared to the sugar, the starch provides the energy slower. Okay, so now let's discuss about what are the sources of the starch. And the sources of the starch are, sources means what? In our previous lesson also we have discussed sources means what, from where we are getting. Okay, so from where we are getting the starch, which are the sources of the starch? The sources of the starch are wheat, rice, maize, bajra, potato and sweet potato. Okay, so all these are the different foodstuffs from that we are getting the starch. Okay, so it is all about the carbohydrate. Okay, so let's revise, let's take the recap of what we have discussed today. Nutrients means what? Nutrients are the substances that an organism needs for growth, repair and the maintenance of its body. Okay, there are, what are the components of the food? Nutrients, roughage and water. These are the components of the food, which are the different nutrients, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. These are the different nutrients. Among these nutrients, today we have discussed about the carbohydrate. There are the two types of the carbohydrate, sugars and starch. And sugars means what? Simple carbohydrate. They have sweet taste, they give instant energy. Sources of sugars are glucose, cane sugar and different fruits. What about the starch? Starch is the store food material of the plant. It is a complex carbohydrate. It is a tasteless and odorless and white powder when it is in a pure form. They provide the energy slower as compared to sugar. And the sources of starch are wheat, rice, maize, bajra, potato and sweet potato. Okay, so this is all about today. So today I'll end my point. I'll see you in the next video. For today, thank you.